Good morning children and welcome to my new class. So as you all remember that we were doing verbs and its kinds. We have finished the different kinds of verbs and we have already discussed what are transitive and what are intransitive verbs. So today we'll be moving on with the exercises. So here are the exercises. Let us start the first exercise, exercise 11.1. Pick out the verbs in the following sentences and write whether these are transitive or intransitive. So as I have already told you that you can very easily identify transitive or intransitive verbs using the objects. If there is an object and the verb is acting on the object, then it is a transitive verb. So let us start this. I'll just tell you how you have to do it. Okay, fine. Here, let us start this. Randomly, we'll be doing two or three and the rest will be done by you. Suppose if we want to do the first one, everyone followed the plan. So now what is the way of doing this? Right? First, try to identify the verb. Everyone followed the plan. So followed is my verb. And now is it answering the question what? Followed what? So followed the plan. So now we have an object here, right? So verb is there and the object is there. So now since both of them are there, then what will it become? It will become a transitive. So here in the blank you will write transitive verb. You will have to underline followed and you will have to write transitive. I hope this is clear to you. So let us move on and see the next one. Look at the fourth one. My father snores at night. Now here again, let us try and identify the verb. So snores is the verb. But there is no object here. There is no object. What question is not being answered? So this will be intransitive. So in the blank here, you will be writing intransitive. You'll underline snores because the verb is there, but it is intransitive. Okay. So this is how you have to do it. Next. Some people follow a strict diet schedule. So let us again do it. Let us identify the verb. Some people follow. So this is my verb. Follow what? What is being answered? A strict diet schedule. So this is my object, right? So now here this is transitive. Okay. Next. Moving on to the next exercise, 11.2. Pick out the objects in the following sentences and write whether they are direct or indirect objects. Now, this is also going to be very interesting. Let us do it. Look at the first one. I will tell you a top secret. Now, here again, there is a trick. Let us first identify the verb. I will tell you. So, will tell. Of course, tell is the main verb. And will is the helping verb. So we'll take tell as the verb. I will tell. Now there are two objects. One is you and the other is a top secret. So now will tell what a top secret. So this is the direct object. And tell you. This is the indirect object. I hope this is clear to you. The verb which is acting directly on some object is the direct object. And the other, normally a non-living thing is a direct object. And the living thing in that, a human or anybody, is the indirect object. Let us do one more. Look at the fourth one. The doctor gave me some orange syrup to drink. Now here again, gave. This is my verb. Now gave what? Some orange syrup. So some orange syrup will become the direct object and me will become the indirect object. So I hope this is clear to you, right? So here there are 11 parts in this and we have done 2. I hope that you all will be able to do it. Now, this is the last exercise, exercise 11.3. In the following sentences, pick out verbs and tell whether they are principal or auxiliary. This is very easy. See, we have already done principal verbs and auxiliary verbs. So, I'll be giving exercise 11.3 as a homework to you. And in my next class, I'll randomly discuss the answers with you. So, this is for you to do. So, I hope you'll all do this in your books very neatly and complete the work. So, have a nice day and keep learning.